coming to you from the swimming hole in Stowmont, a pool and fitness centre, non-profit, founded by Jack and Donna. We're here tonight to deliver to you session three of Burton's home workouts for riding. And tonight is our final session, and it is a shred-ready workout. All you're going to need today is two paper plates. If you don't have those, you could use paper towels. We're using a kettlebell tonight. You could use a piece of wood or a brick or even a dry bag with a weighted object folded up to use for a weight. So we're going to get you started with a warm-up here, and then we're going to get right into it. Just nice and gentle on an inhale. We're going to sink into a squat nice and slow. We're focusing on the muscles that you primarily use to ride. More difficulty this week, more multi-joint moves. We're going to get your heart rate up at the same time. So in your warm-up squat, this is a good movement rehearsal. Hips to the back, press through the back half of your foot. Abdominals engage, back long and flat, and chest lifted. Nice work, that's it. We're going to move you into a lunge. Right foot steps back, sit down, and then step together. These are some foundational movements that we're using to help you get warmed up for tonight's work. Ooh, it feels good to go nice and light before we get into some of the fun stuff later. Here comes the last one. Now we're going to take you into a side movement, lateral lunge, step and center. Really going to be focusing on the stabilizers in your back today. Firing your abs, really getting those leg muscles burning. We've got a couple of humdingers coming at you once we get warmed up. A little bit more difficulty tonight, so we are going to take a little bit of time before we get into our first sequence for a little instruction. We'll be cueing you with tips along the way. All right, center it up, nice job. We're gonna finish off with some rotation. Little swing of the arms. Really want to get you ready to do all the moves that you do on your board so that you're ready to give it your all when you hit the slow to ride next time. Last one. Coming up, good. Take your right foot back. Let's get you all stretched out through the trunk before we head off here. Back we go. So these exercises are going to give you the ability to ride harder, longer, and not be calling it quits early because your body's tired. No. Last one. You got it. Okay, here we go. First sequence, lower body and core. We're going to give you a little demo with a piece of birch wood here. We're going to be working on a kettlebell swing. We're going to show you how to do a deadlift first to work on your form. Stand up nice and tall, tummy and tight. You're going to send your hips to the back, chest is out. We're going to sink forwards, chest is now down, and we're going to snap the hips forwards to bring ourselves back up. Now as we advance that to a swing, we're going to take an overhand grip over our log. We're going to initiate with the deadlift, and then we're going to swing up. A little softening in the knees. We're going to add an exhale. Nice cardiovascular component as well. So come and join with us here. We're going for 10. Swim's also great at keeping your lower back muscles. When you're riding, that lower back is just keeping you upright the majority of the time. It's good to get that nice and trained right now. Last one, right here. Okay, next move. We're going to go for a figure eight, multi-dimensional. Take your wood or your kettlebell, and we're going to take this wood, we're going to go from the front, we're going to slide it between the legs to the back, and then we're going to come back up. Hips sink, hips extend. So just imagine the movement that you're doing on your board as you adjust to different terrain and snow conditions. Ready for anything, and we really like the way this works on our coordination as well. We're taking the 220. This is our warm-up round. For our following two rounds, you're going to have the option of adding additional weight. We're going to fang things up with a heavier kettlebell on our next set. Good little rhythm going there. Start to notice that heart rate beginning to rise. Four more. Three, you got it. Two, one. Okay, time for a little learning again. We're going to go into a lunge, and we're going to add in a deadlift as well. So a lot of balance coming up. You're going to take your object in your right hand. We're going to step into a lunge. Make sure your knee's behind your front toe. Then we're going to step up, long flat back. We're going to reach the foot forwards. The toe can be down. We can bring it all the way up. A lot more challenging. Here we go. Four more on this same side. Breathe. Now we know balance is vital. This is a great way to practice. Off your board so you're ready to go throw it down on the mountain. One more. Beautiful. Switch sides. Left hand, left leg goes back. Little step. Together. Reach it forwards. Four more.
Look out. It's good moments for great for getting ready for your board. Get all those little muscles stabilized. The ankle, knee, those little muscles around your foot. Get you nice and ready. Last one.
Okay, we're ready to step it up. Let's go for let's do it. Okay, time to get to it. Two more rounds. Time for business, everyone. Here it is. We got 10. Other things you could use here is a piece of wood, dumbbell, working on strength, endurance, cardiovascular fitness. Give me one more. Pop it up there. Good. Kettlebell, left hand. We're going to go front to back. Ready? Keep your breath moving. Abdominals are engaged. Firing those stabilizers in the lower back.
What about you guys? I'm starting to feel this in all of my lower body.
It's a burn. You got it. That's it. Okay. Right hand. Right foot goes back. Slow and controlled of the lunge. Press through your front foot. Lift the chest. Sink. Step it up. The tighter you have your core, the easier it's going to be to keep your balance. Remember, we're thinking about snapping those hips forwards, hips to the back, hips to the front. Working every muscle here. Figure eight's coming your way. Here we go, left hand leads. Four, three, two, keep rate down. We get the heart rate up here. So these are a long jump. We're looking for maximum distance covered in one leap. Now, modification would be a big step and little light jumps back. Tummy in tight to control your foot strike. We're going to go with a long jump. Ready? Here we go. Agility, coordination, high intensity move. You've got 45 seconds. Oh, it's a fun one. Come on, 10 more seconds. You got it. Shoulders and chest. Center hold. We've got 45 seconds. You're halfway there. Slow and steady. Here we go. Tap. Tap. Pull the hips up. Tap. Tap. We've got time for four more. Two or three. Let's do it again. That was a really nice job on that. Really working on your athletic ability. Changing directions. De-accelerating. Also great practice in the park. If you got any landing coming down, whether it's a good one or a bad one, if you have nice strong legs, keep you stable. Changing to different movements. Never going to be completely still on your board. shoulders, straight body one. Keep that line as you lift one hand and tap, tap, pike, pike. Looking strong, keep it moving. Okay, here comes the treat.
for good measure. Yes, row. You got 8. Press through the front heel, light touch on the back foot, tummy in tight. Control on the way up and down. Exhale it out. Switch. Nice. You know, it's push-up time again. Let's go do it. Let's get after it. Plank it up. 3, 2, 1. Press. 3, 2, 1. Press. Going for 10, and then we're going to give you
10% more than you think you have on land, and I bet it'd be 20% on the snow. So here it is. To advance, we're going to drop down and lift up. You have the option of resting your head and neck down. One more. Excellent. Beautiful. Okay, here comes our twist. Trunk twister. Woo. We're going to go with the kettlebell. We're going to hold it by the horns. Long flat back. We're going to dip down to the side and then take it to the other side. Now you could advance by picking up one foot or both feet. Eight more. Seven. Six. Five. Four. And these guys look good. Three. Two. One. Yay. You can feel those kettlebells are a runner. Okay, next up, we sort of balance the front and the back side of the body. Spend a lot of time with your back muscles having to stabilize, and we'll work on that here. So just make sure you're not hitting your weights. We're going to give you a hitchhiker. Hands out, palms down, thumbs up. You're going to press your feet into the mat, squeeze the glutes, we're going to lift up and lower down. Little ones at the top for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stretch it back. We got a great trail here in Stowe, the Bruce Trail that you can ride down long. It's hitching a ride on the way back up, so that's a little double benefit there for each other. Okay, here we go. You got 10. Two more. You got it. Twist time. So I'm gonna keep my heels planted. I'm gonna keep my back as long and flat as I can. I'm gonna recline a little further back for this one. I'm gonna see if I can get my kettlebell past my hip. My eyes are gonna follow. The further you go, the worse it gets.
Yep.
It's a bear. Use that breath. Four, three, two, and one. Excellent. Okay, time for you to hitchhike. Let's get it done. We're going to make it a little bit trickier if you want a little extra salt and pepper on yours. Pick up your feet as well. Hold them up there. Lift. Eight small, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, here we go. Jackknife. Got a trusty birch wood, a Burton birch, love it. Tuck, stretch. Advanced option. A little bit slower on this. To make it easier, don't go so low with the feet. Two more. Oh yeah. Okay, bonus extra. Can you hold it for me? 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, a little lower, 3, 2, and 1. Fantastic. Okay. Plant those heels down. Recline back. You might choose to lift your feet. Here we go. Two more. That's it. You got it. Hitchhiker time. Right now on the tummy. Thumbs are up, hands level with the shoulder. Lift and lower. Bonus extra, hold it up there. Bring your thumbs forwards, bring it back. 5 more right here. It's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Great job. Go ahead and press it back. Bring the hips back over the heels. Slowly bring those hands in. Very slowly coming up into a standing position. Stretch it up overhead. That's incredible. Hey, again, this is Charlotte.
And Heidi.
Thanks for tuning in for us and working on your fitness at home, getting ready to get on the board with Burton next season. Great job. Thanks for tuning in. Over and out from the swimming hole and stoke them off.